Michael, thanks so much for joining us. What led to your decision to join the Arizona Coyotes out in the desert for the next couple of years?
Yeah, they just kept calling and checking in, and just showed interest from the start. And obviously, as a player, you wanna go to a team that thinks that you can help them win. So, and like I said, they were really persistent, and obviously, it's gonna be a lot of fun down there.
When you're in this position as a free agent here, you look at the team. Obviously, you want to know the direction of the team. What are some of the things that jumped out for the Yotes as far as their youth movement and things that you like that they're doing down there in the desert?
Yeah, obviously, I only play them a couple times a year, but they have a good young team down there. They're playing with a lot of speed. They have some good puck movement, moving the defensemen, and every time we played them in the desert, it was a pretty tough game for us. So I hope I can come in there and help them win and get to the playoffs.
Hey, Michael, congratulations on your new contract with the Coyotes, and got to know you a little bit near the end with the New Jersey Devils, and I wish you nothing but the best. Did you get an opportunity to talk to Coach Rick Tocchet? I know he's well-respected by his players, and did that have any bearing in where you were going to sign at all, or did you have any conversation at all?
No, most of the stuff went through my agent, but he obviously kept me really up to date what's going on and who's been calling and who's been like showing the most interest. So, and like I said, Phoenix, where they were, Arizona, were always right there. I always kept checking in, and I thought that was a good fit. So did my agent, and nice to go down there. I already talked to Stefan. He said just great things about the team and the area down there, so I'm going to be excited to check it out myself.
We know it's a fast game these days, and it's all about speed, and when we watch you on the ice sometimes it looks like you have rocket boosters below your kneecaps. How do you think your game and your speed fits into what Arizona is trying to do for the next couple of seasons?
Yeah, I think, like you said, the NHL is getting faster every year, it seems like, and I'm trying to do my best to keep up with those young guys, and I'm just going to try to go in there, play the same way as I always play, use my speed, and hopefully create some more room for my line mates. And yeah, but my game hasn't changed, and I think as long as I can use my speed to my advantage, I should be fine, so hopefully it lasts a few more years.
So you get the 3-year deal there, but then it sounds like you had a little side deal inside the Grabner household. This tweet, you've agreed to a deal, some details still being worked out though, but you're taking out the garbage at least once a week, and the wife's going to let you go play golf without getting mad. Tell us about how those negotiations went, because I know there's a lot of people out there, myself included, that want to know how we can work out the best deal for us golf-wise.
Yeah, it was just a little fun thing. Thought I saw something out there, but yeah, my wife's a good sport about it, and she renegotiated a little deal. I'm pretty lazy with bringing out the garbage or doing chores, so she does most of that stuff, and I made a little deal with her that I'll try to help her out more, and I can play some more golf.
Was this before you knew you were heading to Arizona? Because Arizona, plenty of golf courses out there to choose from. So did you work out the details of that contract before you knew you were signing with the Yotes?
Yeah, that was before, so I guess I got lucky.
See? That's right. That's predicting the future right there. Well, Michael Grabner, we wish you all the best in your future. Look forward to watching you next season in Arizona.
Yeah, thank you very much. Thanks all for right. having me.